Hey, how you doing today? My name is Relia, and thank you so much for stopping by. Today we're playing Hollow Knight, and I want to show you how to defeat Nightmare King Grimm. So I've already defeated Nightmare King Grimm earlier on the save game file, so I'm going to do it here from God Home. It's the exact same fight. Just to show you the charms I'm using, I'm going Mark of Pride, Shaman Stone, Unbreakable Strength, and Sharp Shadow. Sharp Shadow makes it so that way whenever we dash through Nightmare King Grimm, we're dealing a little bit of damage, which is going to be super helpful. Unbreakable Strength and Mark of Pride are going to help with the damage with the nail, and Shaman Stone is going to be super helpful when we're using our Abyss Shriek, and I'll show you exactly when we're using all of this stuff, so let's go ahead and jump right in. One of the first attacks I see Grimm do very often is the dash and uppercut. And so what he's going to do is come at you right here. He's going to dash across the screen, taking up about 25% of it, and then come up into the air. And what you want to do is just dash towards him with your sharp shadow, and you will be in the perfect placement every single time. The sharp shadow makes this part super, super easy. The second attack that we see Nightmare King Grimm do a lot is the fire bats. And so the difference between regular Grimm and Nightmare King Grimm is that Nightmare King Grimm will do four bats, starting with one up, one down, one up, one down. So you want to jump early on, but not so high that you hit the first bat, and then dash to miss the two bats that are going to be going on the bottom. So depending on how far away Nightmare King Grimm is from you, you're going to want to do a jump and then dash. Sometimes you want to try and stay in the air a little bit longer with your double jump, and sometimes you just want to kind of do a short hop and then do your dash towards Grimm. You can get two hits, and sometimes if you're lucky, you can get a third hit, and that's without Quick Slash attached. The third attack that we see is the floor spikes, and these are just like with regular Grimm, only Grimm does not leave himself open to an attack, so you just have to see the floor spikes coming, get out of the way, and it's the same as before. It might be just a little bit faster than with regular Grimm, and with that two damage with all of these attacks, it can be a little bit nerve-wracking, but you're gonna get through it just fine. The next attack is the dive slash, and Nightmare King Grimm will wrap himself up in his cloak. He will come down at a 45 degree angle-ish, and then he will dash usually towards you in your direction. And the really hard part about this one is that he leaves a flame trail behind him. So having that sharp shadow charm is gonna make it a lot easier if you just wanna get out of there. The other option is to actually jump over his attack, head over to one side, either the left or the right, and then you want to use a down strike, but right on his shoulder, because it is very, very easy to miss this down strike. If you go directly above his head, he actually brings himself up just a little bit, and you will be taking damage. You want to be right about here, right on his shoulder, and if you're moving too much away from him, you're just going to fall right into the flames and take damage. This is a high risk and only a medium reward attack because you're only going to get one damage off. But if you mess up, you're taking two hits. So be warned, sometimes it might be worth it just to get out of the way of this attack. So the next attack is the Flame Spawner. And this one will come out whenever he is at 75% health, 50% health, and 25% health. So every time you see him puff up into like a big puffer fish and he's doing all these flames, that's how you know roughly how much health he has left. And also you're just looking for the flame ball thing that makes it all the way to the bottom of the ground. The one that makes it to the bottom of the ground, you know you're gonna have to jump over it. So just really watch out for this area right here and you'll be able to jump over these just fine. Every once in a while you might have to do a double jump to get out of the way, but usually single jumps will do just fine, and just do your best to get out of the way. Last but not least is the Flame Pillar, and this is what's going to allow you to deal the most damage to Grimm by far. This is my favorite attack. Whenever he does this, you want to stay kind of far away from him and let him do two Flame Pillars. When he starts the third one, jump and get one nail attack, and as the fourth one is going, you want to be almost directly underneath Grimm, or even just slightly off to the side whenever possible, just like this, and get off your Abyss Shriek. this is by far how you're gonna deal the most damage, and you always wanna make sure you have at least enough soul to be able to get this off. It's more important to have enough soul for this than it is to get a heal off. Note that if you do manage to stagger Grimm, he will burst open and turn into a bunch of little bats, and you will tell which one he is because he's the only bat with eyes. And you can get a little bit of damage off, but if you need the health, you know what, you can get off one or two health right here. And if you've got the soul, go for it, but he's really hard to hit, and I wouldn't risk using an Abyss Shriek in this area. Even though it takes up a large area, it's not worth using the damage in that way. Just either heal or just take a breather and get ready for the next spot. And just like that, we defeat Nightmare King Grimm, and I hope that you found something in this tutorial helpful that's gonna make it easier to beat him. If you want even more Hollow Knight tips, tricks, and how-to videos, please be sure to subscribe. My name is Relia, and I'll talk to you again more soon.